classically this particle is bound there, but quantum mechanically, to bond a particle, quantum mechanically, to bind a particle, then an infinite potential is to be applied on the walls. So as long as the potential is finite, then the particle cannot be restricted, because we are having the phenomenon of tunneling. Now, in tunneling phenomenon, a particle actually strikes with the barrier, and it approximately, for a single passage, it will have to strike, means approximately 1,000,000 times to the barrier, then it get a chance to go through. So in tunneling, the tunneling makes this problem or this state is a scattering state, not a bound state. For a bound state, we will have to apply infinite potential on the walls. As here, we have applied infinite potential on the walls. V of x was 0 inside the well, while V was infinite on the walls. So, such a situation will have the possibility or the tunneling, means it will cause no tunneling then. While for infinite potential in quantum mechanics, we are having the possibility of tunneling, and it will be no more a bound state but a scattering state in quantum mechanics. So I can summarize this one, that if E is less than V, such that V at minus infinity and V at plus infinity, let me enclose this one, V at minus infinity and plus infinity means when the energy is less than the potential energy, such that the potential energy at the minus end is infinite, while at the plus end it is also infinite potential, then I will say that this will have a bound state. Such state I will then call a bound state. And when energy will be greater than, if V is infinite, or here is end, and here is or, means it will consider one end as well, plus infinite, then this will have scattering state. Like, if we are having E greater than V at any end, whether at minus end or at plus end, even the potential will be infinite, but E is greater than that one, it will be a scattering state. While if the energy will be less than the potential, we will have a bound state. So, in order to stop the leakage, to stop the leakage of electron or any other particle through a potential, we will have to consider the potential infinite on both ends. This will stop the tunneling and we will have bound state. If any of the end energy will become greater than the potential, we will have scattering state. And even if classical mechanically a particle is seen to be inside a bound state, but for a finite value of potential in quantum mechanics, this will be a scattering state, not a bound state. Before going into the delta function potential, let me first discuss what is the delta function. This is also called the Dirac delta function. And what is the Dirac delta function? The Dirac delta function is not exactly a function, but it behaves like a function. It is also called a peak function or a spike function. Let's consider that we are having our axis like this. This is the x-axis and this is the delta function, delta x. Now this function is such that it is zero everywhere except when it reaches the x equal to zero, it goes infinitely high. Now this width that I have considered is just an exaggeration, because I cannot then show it just like a line like this. This peak is such that this delta x is going to, or I will say, equal to infinity, means it goes to infinity when x is equal to 0. This is the x equal 0 point. When x is equal to 0, the delta function becomes undefined, goes to infinity, and it is 0 when x is not equal to 0. So for all other points, this delta x is equal to 0. Now it's such a thin, it is very thin and it is very high, such that if I integrate this function from minus infinity to plus infinity, and from minus infinity to plus infinity delta x dx, such that this will become equal to 1, means the area under the curve, this area all will be such that this will be equal to 1 if x will be equal to 0, and it will become equal to 0 if x will not be equal to 0. So this is the integration, means when I find the area under the curve area under the function is delta x. So this will be equal to 1 for only x equal to 0, while when x is non-zero, it will give you 0. The total area will be equal to 0. That's why it is also called a single-valued function. If I consider it on any other point instead of 0, x equal to 0, for any other point, for example, I write integral from minus infinity to plus infinity, delta x minus a and dx, then this will be equal to 1 if x will be equal to a, and this will be equal to 0 if x will not be equal to a. This is also true for any other point. Similarly, if I associate this function with any other function, then this function means, and I do integrate, then the area of this function is equal to 1. So this is just like multiplication by 1. and it is a single value, so it will give the value of the function only at a single point. So this delta function is used where we want to remove singularity from a given function. For example, if I apply this delta function on a function f of x, delta x minus a dx. Now, if I apply it, then this delta x minus a will give value only when x will be equal to a. For all other points, this will be equal to 0. So we will have our function equal to f of a only. Because for when x is equal to a, this integration will give 1, and that's why the function will get a single value, and this will be equal to f of a. Now for further details, on Dirac delta function, which we have discussed in the classical electrodynamics subject, and this we have discussed in the early lectures in review on Maxwell, review on Maxwell's equations. So further details can be seen for the delta function. Now what we are considering here, we are considering a delta function potential. Now is we consider an infinite square well, the potential equal to 0. For a harmonic oscillator, we consider the potential half kx square, and then the free particle, again the potential was 0, it was a free particle. And now we consider a delta function potential such that v of x equal alpha delta x. Now this potential I consider is minus. So minus potential means now the potential, it is a spike upward, so it will be a spike downward due to this minus sign. While alpha is a constant, and the dimensions of alpha will be, I can check it from here. I know that the dimensions of delta x, means in one dimension delta x, it is equal to 1 over x, the dimensions of delta x. In three dimension, it is 1 over r, which is 1 over x cube. So we are having the dimension of delta x is 1 over x, then alpha will be in the units of, this is energy. So energy into length. So alpha is a constant and its dimensions are actually in joule energy and length sub meter. So joule meter will be the unit of alpha, the dimensions of it will be energy into length. So I can plot this delta function here. Let's say this is our delta function delta x, and this is our x. So the potential will be something like this, that it will start from here and then it will go down, and this will be our delta potential. So at this point we are having minus alpha times delta x, minus alpha and delta x. So I will not write minus here, because here the value is automatically minus. So it is alpha delta x potential. Now we will have to solve to write the Schrödinger wave equation. So the Schrödinger wave equation will be minus h bar square over 2m d square psi over dx square plus V of x psi equals E psi. Now I know that what is V of x, so minus h bar square over 2m d square psi over dx square minus alpha delta x psi equals E psi. So for a delta function, I will have to solve the Schrödinger wave equation. I will calculate separately for bound states and for scattering states. I will calculate separately for them. For bound state, I will take E negative, E less than 0. And for scattering state, I will get E positive, E greater than 0. Why I am taking this one? Because I know that E is the sum of T plus V. So when E minus V is equal to T, the kinetic energy, if V will be greater than the total energy, then the kinetic energy will become negative. Kinetic energy negative means the particle is now bound. So in this situation, we will have E less than 0, negative, the E negative, while when V is less than E, means E is greater, so we will have E greater than 0, and the particle, the kinetic energy will be positive, and the particle will be free to move. So that's the reason that we consider E less than 0 for bound state, while E greater than 0 for the scattering states.